east of the Cauca Valley National Park between the cities of Cleveland and Akron, you'll find a little city by the name of Hudson. And we're going to give you a double dose of that particular city that's home to two members of our Fox 8 team.
Yeah, so like his older brother Scott, Fox 8 sports and news anchor John Sable grew up in Hudson. And he joins us live at a spot that's been a staple in Hudson for nearly 70 years. Hey, guys.
Yeah, guys, this place, Hudson's, has been around since in the 1950s. It was then called Mary and Ted's. We have the owners, JJ and Kevin Altamirri, with us. From two brothers to two brothers, guys. What do we have here in front of us here in terms of spread and drink options that people that haven't been here can look forward to?
So we have our Loaded House chips. It's bacon, diced tomato, gorgonzola cheese, scallions, a balsamic drizzle. We have our French chicken sandwich. It's a house-made French mayo, Swiss on a baguette. And then our signature Hudson burger, both of those are there with our signature house cut fries. Then we've got a mimosa and a smoked old fashioned.
This looks delicious. All of it does, but the old fashioned looks. I'm a big old fashioned guy when not working, of course. And, yes. And of course, here's Scott drinking or eating. While we're talking, you're gonna.
I've done a lot of work. Share some? I've done a lot of work already, John. I need a break.
All right. Well, you continue to eat. Right. We saw Scott's featured segment a little bit ago about how Hudson grew up here mm-hmm. in town and what meant a lot to him. Now it's my turn, and we're gonna show you some places around town that are near and dear to my heart. Hudson is known for this beautiful and historic downtown loaded with shops and restaurants, as well as fantastic schools, a family-oriented community with endless parks, and a whole bunch more. What I'm going to show you today around town are spots that shaped my life when I grew up here. Our first stop, Colony Park, home of three baseball fields, a playground, trails, and picnic areas, but its main attraction are these diamonds.
Baseball is that one sport that really brought my entire family together. My sisters played softball, my brother and I played baseball, my dad coached my sisters here at these fields, and my brother at these fields when we played baseball. It was that one sport that really got us all together as a family of seven growing up. But this particular field is near and dear to my heart. I'm getting a little nostalgic just thinking about it and standing at this very spot at home plate in the batter's box, because in 2000, the summer of that year, I hit my very first home run over a fence in left center field.
It was a moment every young baseball player dreams and remembers. And check this out, my parents still have that baseball all these years later when I was 14 years old. Speaking of baseball, 7 months after that memorable moment on the diamond, I got to meet the greatest Cleveland Indians player of all time, Hall of Fame pitcher Bob Feller, in downtown Hudson, right here at the Learned Al bookstore. Feller was promoting his new book, Bob Feller's Little Black Book of Baseball Wisdom, then. My mom took me here. I got a signed copy and got to shake the Hall of Famer's hand. Two doors down from the bookstore, Dave's Cosmic Subs. If you've ever been in one of these sandwich shops around town, you'll see a ton of classic rock posters and signage inside, as well as people's signatures. My wife and I dated in high school and would come to Dave's for lunch quite frequently. Our signature from 2005, located between these two coolers, still on the wall this very day. And we all remember our first jobs as teenagers, right? Mine was right here at KGK Gardening and Design, working long hours in the hot sun with my best friend, Ryan Lee.
I'm with Ken Carrilla, owner of KGK Gardening and Design here in Hudson, and this is a great a person in my life that helped me develop some hardworking skills, because you, Ken, gave me my first job as a 14-year-old kid here in Hudson. So let's like reminisce some of those old days about what you remember from, you know, little John Sable at the time.
Little John Sable had big feet, and you and Ryan Lee came on board, and we nurtured you into a very productive employee that we gained a lot of respect for one another, and we got to see you grow, which was a lot of fun.
Yeah, I worked here from 2000 throughout high school and through 2006, my junior year of college, and a lot of hard work. A lot of manual labor outside, putting brick patios in, raking mulch, putting in water features like this. Everything that you have done, we did then, and that hard work has really instilled a lot of values in me and my career as well.
A lot of our employees have gone on to, you know, great things, and you as well.
I appreciate that.
We're very proud of you.
Did he just say Little John Sable had big feet?
I did, yeah. I was a little...
What was your size? She like 11 back then?
Back then it was 11. I'm a 13
now.
Oh,
okay.
So,
I was kind of like...
Ken doesn't know I still have big feet.
Yeah, I understand.
Special thanks to Ken Carilla and everyone else that made that possible. Mm-hmm. And thank you guys here at Hudson's, JJ and Kevin. Real quick, if people want to come here, when are you open?
We're open lunch and dinner Monday through Friday, and then breakfast, lunch, and dinner on Saturday. Closed on Sundays.
All right. Thank you guys so much. We're going to dig into this here momentarily.
And a couple more stops on the way.
Well, Scott has got a question. Is it true John's feet are twice
the
size?
Yeah, what?
Is it true John's feet are twice the size of yours?
I knew you were going to say that. And Zoom Scott's over here cracking up because he knew that was coming. The answer is partially, but that's besides. Back to you, Wayne.
Okay. Oh, God. Don't worry about it. You and Dick Gunner can wear the same shoes. That's okay.
See, I knew
it's okay,
go
okay, Scott.
All right.
Yep.
John's
all right.
Like,
more to come coming up later.
They treat you like this all the time. Oh, it's our favorite part of the morning.